Got room for one more?
The Hateful Eight. It is the eighth film directed by Quentin Tarantino. It is a Western mystery film that stars quite a few notable actors, such as Samuel L. Jackson and Kurt Russell. Kurt Russell. I don't know why I keep doing that. It amazes me how many good movies that Quentin Tarantino has released so far. And the ratio between good and bad is, well, they're all good, basically. And if you've seen a Quentin Tarantino movie, you kind of have an idea of what to expect in this movie. It is bloody, violent, good writing, and amazing characters. It takes place a few years after the Civil War, in which eight strangers have to share a lodge as they try to seek refuge from a massive blizzard. From the beginning, you can kind of tell that there's something wrong with these people. And quickly, you try to play bad guy, good guy, who's who. You try to play detective and find out which side are you supposed to be rooting for. You learn little by little about these characters and their intentions. It's very interesting to see these characters in action because of their dialogue and because of the mystery that's behind each and every one of them. Alongside the great acting and dialogue in this movie, there's an amazing score that furthers in creating the tension between the eight characters. Keep in mind that this movie takes place in one location, and in one location is able to keep your focus on it throughout the whole 3 hours. The best characters by far is Major Marcus Warren, who is played by Samuel L. Jackson, and John Ruth, who is played by Kurt Russell, who are both bounty hunters. Every character in this movie is fantastic, but when Samuel L. Jackson's character comes to the screen, when the film is focused on him, he demands your attention. And that's why he is actually my favorite character in this movie. Alongside Kurt Russell's character, you'll find his bounty, who is Daisy DeMorgue, who is set to hang. She is played by Jennifer Jason Leigh, who I hope I pronounced her name correctly. Probably not. The back and forth fighting between the two characters create for a very interesting dynamic between convict and bounty hunter. It was also pretty interesting to see Tim Russ again. You may recognize him from Reservoir Dogs. I first saw him in The Incredible Hulk. He was the Abomination. Good time. He plays Oswaldo Mumbry, the Hangman. Michael Madsen plays Joe Gage, a quiet cowboy traveling to see his mother. Walter Goggins plays Chris Mannix, supposedly the new sheriff of Red Rock. Keep in mind that Red Rock is the location that they're all going to, just to clarify. The final player is Sanford Smithers, a former general of the Confederate. He is played by Bruce Dern. Like I said before, this movie is bloody violent in the good old Tarantino fashion. Limbs flying off, heads exploding, you know, the usual. This movie is a 5 out of 5 stars. I would recommend it to anybody who wants to watch a good movie. I consider this movie a masterpiece. Watch it, guys, and tell me, did you guys enjoy this movie? Tell me down below. Like and subscribe, and see Dog Daniels.